to perform any SQL command in PHP MyAdmin, we first need to select any database and then click on SQL panel. If you don't have any database, then you can simply click on new and create your database. Since I already have a test database, I will be using it. Let us first create a table. To create a table, we use create keyword, which is followed by a table's name and its attribute. We will first create agents table. As you can see that create keyword is followed by table's keyword because we want to create a table. It is followed by the table name, that is agents. And in brackets, we are adding its attribute, that is agents code, agent name, working area, commission, phone number and country, which are followed by their data types. In this table, we are using three data types, character, float and varchar, or variable character. Character is used for identifying characters. It is same as varchar, with only difference being that character has fixed length, but varchar has flexible length. Float is a number based data type that takes single precision floating point number or decimal number. There is also a double, which has double precision decimal point. Let's execute this command by pressing go. On left panel, you can see that we have added our agents table. On expanding the table, we can see all the columns. Let us add some data using insert keyword. You can either add one data at a time or add multiple data at same time. As you can see that insert is followed by the agent's name, which is adding these values using values keyword. The sequence of these values are same as the sequence of attributes of the table. Let us execute this command. As you can see, our query was successfully executed. Let us check our data. You can see that all the data was inserted in our table. Let us try to delete some data from the table using delete keyword. You can see that it is asking for confirmation. Let's press OK. One row was affected. Let us see what happened to our table. As you can see that agent 007 was removed from our table. Here, delete is followed by the table name and a condition using where clause. Where clause is used when we want to perform some operation based on certain condition. These conditions are handled by where clause. In this case, since we want to delete an agent that has agent code of A007, we are using agent code is equal to A007. If you have seen our previous sections about SQL statements, you must have seen there is a truncate statement as well, which works same as delete statement. You may also know the difference. But why do we need truncate when we have delete? It's because truncate is more efficient when deleting all rows from table. It's simply because delete statement will delete rows one by one when deleting all rows, whereas truncate will drop the table and then recreate it, making it more efficient and faster. Let us try to change the structure of our table. We can add or remove any attribute from the table. To add an attribute, we use add keyword along with the table name in alter statement. Let us add email attribute to our table. On left panel, you can see that we have added email attribute to our table. Let us perform select query to confirm it. You can see that email attribute was added in our table as well. Now that we have confirmed this, let us remove email attribute from it. To remove email attribute, we use same statement, but instead of add, we will use drop keyword. It asks for confirmation again. Let's press OK. On left panel, you can see that email attribute was successfully removed. Let us confirm it with select query. With this, we have confirmed that email attribute was removed from our table. Let us change some data from our table, and for that, we will use update keyword. This time, we will try to change phone number of an agent. Let's say agent A008. Let us see what is the phone number of agent A008. You can see that this is the phone number, and now we want to change it. Let us change the phone number of our agent A008 by using update keyword. Update is followed by the table name, which is followed by set keyword, set our column name that we want to update. Let us add the condition where agent code is A008. Let us execute the command. As you can see that one row was affected. Let us see what happened to the phone number of agent A008. As you can see that the phone number of agent A008 was changed to this number. Now we have covered basics of our CRUD operations. Let's move on to primary keys and foreign keys. Let me show you this image again, so that you understand how relations are related to each other. You may pause the video to check it again. Let us first drop the table using drop keyword and recreate it again. You can see that the agents table was removed from our left panel. Now we will create a customers table and link agents table to the customers table. In this statement, everything is same. Except the agent code attribute. Here we used references keyword that tells SQL engine that agent code column references to the primary key of agent table. With this, we have linked agents table and customers table. In this, data header in the agent code column should exist in agents table as well. If they don't exist in agent table, then it will cause some error. Now we will create orders table and link it to agents as well as customers table. In this table, you can see that there is date data type. It stores dates in the attribute. If you want to add date and time both, then use timestamp data type. If you don't add any value in timestamp, then it takes your server's date time as default value. When we are creating tables, you must have seen not null multiple times. It is just a constraint. It says that the value in this column cannot be null value, which means that it cannot be empty. Similarly, we have unique constraint as well. Because sometimes we may need values that are unique but may not be primary keys. Like in college, we have enrollment ID, which can be considered as primary key. And we also have a roll number, which must be unique in a class. Thus, it can be set as a unique value, even though it is not a primary key. Let's execute this to add the data in our table. Now that we have executed primary keys and foreign keys to link the tables, we will be performing join operations on agents, customers, and orders.